بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
So if you look at fasting, we fast for the month of Ramadan. Sometimes non-Muslims look at us, you fast for the month, I'll be dead by then. No, it's from dawn to dusk every day. Simple. It has a lot of goodness for your health. And spiritually, as soon as the month of Ramadan enters, ask the Muslims, they will tell you there is a different spirituality. It is so elevated that you would need to be a submitter in order to feel it. Subhanallah. Amazing. And thereafter, you would have compassion, because when you are hungry, you reach out to the poor. You have food you're staying away from. For 1 month, you're staying away from food and permissible sexual desires and so on, within from dawn to dusk. That should help you protect your chastity outside that month. If I could do it for 1 month, why can I not do it for the rest of the 11 months? Number one. Number two is, if you can protect yourself from eating what is otherwise permissible for 1 month of the calendar, why can you not protect yourselves from eating that which is prohibited for the rest of the 11 months? Amazing. And thereafter, you would also be able to reach out to the poor. I have food, but I'm not eating it. What about those who don't have the food? So this is why a lot of people tend to give out the charities in the month of Ramadan. The hadith says, "Kana ajwada ma yakunu fi Ramadan hina yalqahu Jibril fayudarisuhu al-Quran." The Prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him, was a very generous man. He was more generous than the wind that would blow. When wind blows, its generosity is such that everyone feels it. So the Prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him, his generosity was immense. And in the month of Ramadan, it was even more, because the angel Gabriel used to come to him and they used to learn the Quran. They used to read the Quran to one another. Amazing. What a beautiful saying.
الورد بثاما وينشر أطيب العطر وتحيا في نجاحات بنور الحق والنصر.